We were very aware that Grimlock in particular was a real fan favorite, so we wanted to make sure that we incorporated a lot of what people loved about him from the original cartoon and update him in a way that makes him like even more menacing and cool.
Yeah, I mean, the G1 cartoon is definitely the origin of all the characters that we've done. So with the Dinobots in particular, because they're ferocious, I think the G1 cartoon was a little maybe kid-friendly, so I think we brought a little more ferociousness to these metal dinosaurs that Shockwave ends up bringing to the planet.
Sure, whenever we come up with a new group or a new classification of guys, we try to do something that makes them stand out from the crowd. For the Dinobots, maybe you could talk about the particular things that we did to separate them.
Yeah, I mean, one thing about the other characters, they all have a particular color scheme, so you have Bumblebee's yellow, and the Dinobots are all very similar in their color schemes. They're different types of metals. Maybe three different colors. Swoop, for instance, has a lot more red on him. Just their materials in general are different from everybody else. So they have a different type of gun gray metal and a reflective gold metal. And in addition to that, I just go back to them, making them as menacing as possible. They're beasts, really, when they transform. So making them a little bit scarier, more ferocious than the other characters.
A very muscular feel, big shoulders, big hands.
Huge feet and yeah. Big boots.
Sort of like reptilian segmentation of their armor and all that sort of thing.
Some have wings, some have claws or I guess plates, like the one that's more of a stegosaurus.
Well, when we're starting any new character, Tej, our game director, has the overall vision for the game, so he'll be involved in the early concepting of things. We'll start with doing hundreds of sketches of characters until we nail it to his satisfaction, then we'll start to bring other departments in, the animators and designers, and make sure it's going to work for their needs as well.
The Dinobots are pretty iconic from the get-go, so, and with most of the characters in Transformers universe, we're still delving back into Generation 1, so we have a nice ball of clay to start with, and then we're trying to modernize them or make them more interesting for new viewers, and then also just to bring the High Moon style across all of the characters. But the story and how they were developed in our particular game story, I think, has played a big role in what they looked like and how they're going to interact with the other characters. But we do a lot of sketches, probably 40 to 50 sketches of each character and their alternate form, and then as many examples as we can possibly provide for everyone to kind of choose from, or to Frankenstein into one final guy. In designing the Dinobots or any of the Transformers, we start with their alt form, which is in some cases a vehicle, a plane, or in this case it's a dinosaur. And so when they transform into their robot mode, you want to see those pieces of either the car or the plane, but in this specific instance, you know, where do the claws go and how do they transform? We use them as shoulder pads or as a jetpack or as a boot or a knee pad or some evidence that you can see that they came from there, because they're Dinobots to begin with. So you're more interested probably to see them in their metallic dinosaur form than in their robot form. So but we have to make them equally as cool across the board. So you want to have claws and tails and wings. And
we work with the animators to usually pick one iconic feature. It's different for every character, but we'll pick one and we track it during the transform animation so you can always keep your eye on, you know, the head of this guy as it transforms into the chest of the alt form or whatever.
A favorite?
I like Swoop, personally. He just looks cool, like a jet fighter.
I have to say they're not called a brontosaurus anymore, right? It's a
patasaurus?
Yeah. I think Sludge's robot design and his alt form design are pretty tough. I don't want to say he looks as tough as Grimlock, but he's pretty tough looking.